If you've scaled a mountain, played a grueling sport, or even just walked around on a hot day, you'll likely feel the need to quench your thirst with some cool H2O. So, you fill your bottle with water, which comes from rivers, wells, or the ocean. But what about the animals surrounded by that water? Fish, in particular. This may sound a bit strange, but with all the swimming they do fish get thirsty too? Well, what is thirst anyways? When you feel dehydrated, you search for a source of water. It is a conscious drive to drink water. This drive to drink water in land-based creatures is a way to ensure that the body maintains a healthy balance of water and salts. Water is the essential solvent for life, in which all the molecules of your body float and carry out their necessary chemical reactions. It is the fluid in which all your cells are bathed. Maintaining this fine balance is called maintaining homeostasis. Remember, your body continually loses water through sweating or panting, peeing, and excreting water-soluble waste. Even the simple act of breathing lets out a little water. So you drink water to maintain that balance. You quench your thirst. By this definition, would fish get thirsty and drink water? How can fish feel a strong urge to drink water or be thirsty when they're surrounded by water all the time? Well, it actually depends on the fish. Fish like the hagfish maintain their internal saltiness at the same level as the ocean around them, so they don't need to drink. They satisfy their water and salt needs by osmosis. Such fish are called osmoconformers. Sharks are another example of this. They don't need to drink at all, so no thirst. Most fish, however, maintain a different internal salt concentration than their surroundings. These fish are called osmoregulators. There are two kinds of environments that fish live in: freshwater and seawater. Freshwater fish live in water with very low salt concentrations. Their blood has a higher salt concentration than the water with which they are surrounded. They run a high risk of having their blood diluted if they actively drink water, but they also risk losing salt to the surrounding water. So what do they do to counteract this? They absorb water through their skin and gills through the process of osmosis, then extract the little salt from that water. Their kidneys will then work to urinate out all that excess water. Here too, they don't drink, and so they aren't ever thirsty. Saltwater fish have the opposite problem. They maintain a lower concentration of salt in their bodily fluids than the water around them. The external salty water can threaten to dehydrate them by pulling water out of their body. These fish actively drink water, but then they have an excess of salt in their body. Fortunately, their gills have evolved ways to excrete the excess salt from their body. And here we thought gills were only for gaseous exchange. Some fish can even switch between these two strategies. Fish that migrate between saltwater and freshwater, such as salmon, which migrate from the sea to the river to spawn, literally change their body to adapt to freshwater. Many fish cannot do this, which is why if they're moved to a water body with different levels of salinity, they'll die. So fish, especially saltwater fish, drink water, but do they ever get thirsty? Well, they probably don't feel thirsty like you or any other land animal. Land animals have to seek out water when they feel a lack in their body. Fish basically live in water, so they don't have to seek it out. If a saltwater fish is dehydrated, its body will sense this, and the fish will simply swallow the water in its mouth. So there's really no chance for them to ever be thirsty.